Hey there guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Pretty Poison, a South African swimmer. Today I bring for you guys a budget build, but I must say out of all my budget builds, I think this one is by far my most favorite. It is a one bedroom and one bathroom house, so it is for a single sim, or it could be for a couple, then they will have a little bit more money. But yeah, so for the exterior I tried to use like some brown tones and a bit of reddish tones, you know, like the roof tiles, it's kind of like a reddish color. So then for the walls I played around with some wooden colors, but then I went for a lighter option. I did not want to go for that dark option. And then for the trimming at the bottom, what do you call that again? I can't remember the base of the house. Any case, I used that, also that wooden texture for that part of the house. Then I used, oh yeah, by the way, this build is base game and seasons pack only. So yeah, so I used seasons staircase for the entrance outside there in the front and in the back. And then I also used the windows from seasons. So with the wood elements for the exterior, I don't have the same brown swatches for everything, so it doesn't match up 100%. I'm sure a lot of you know the struggle of like swatches not matching up of different items in Sims, but I tried to get it as close as possible. I find that the stairs, for example, seems a bit lighter than other elements on the exterior. And for the wooden floor, I couldn't like find a swatch that matches the stair swatch, because I kind of wanted that wood color to go from the outside inside, but unfortunately I was not able to do that. Now we're in the kitchen part, so I used the cheapest base game counters, and then I used the fridge we got not so long ago, and then also a nice stove. And then I also put like a basic bed. It's also like, I think, the cheapest bed, so you can upgrade it once your sim makes money. And then also in the bathroom I put like cheap furniture, or plumbing is a better word for that. And then we have a little dining room, we have a little living room area, but it doesn't have a TV because they can't afford it yet. But I mean, that can come later on. So the reason I put an easel is because I personally do paintings, let my sim make paintings to make money quicker. That's like what I do for my sims to make money quicker. I think in most of my budget builds I put an easel because of that. So then your sim can make money and, you know, upgrade the house and just make it a bit prettier and whatever. So in the kitchen, I put a basin for them to do dishes, and I also put a coffee machine. So yeah, this is really, like I said, is probably my most favorite budget build I've ever done. It just came out much better. You see, with practice, I'm getting better at making budget builds. So I'm quite happy with this one. Now I'm just adding like some extra stuff around the house. Gonna do some lighting as well in the house. I tried to play around with the lights and not just use the saucer lights, but I did end up using the bigger saucer lights in this house. But I do try and use different lights. It's just I'm not happy. For example, this light you see, it is cool and stuff, but the walls, like the top half of the walls, is still dark, and I don't like it. So that's why I just went for the brighter saucer light. But I sometimes try and use different lights, like in the bedroom I'm using those bedside lamps. So right now I'm just trying to add some clutter as well, as you can see. And yeah, usually I can't really add clutter in my budget builds, it's just the budget doesn't allow it. But with this house, I really try to make the house smaller than I usually do. I think I try and make them too big. So this time I tried to make the house a bit smaller, which really worked out nice for the budget build. So I'm quite happy with that. So in this bedroom, the bed is like in the corner, but your sim can scoot over, and in a second sim can sleep on the bed. Like, that is at least a thing that Sims does have, finally. on a finally, it's been a while, but I mean, at least you could do that. So you don't have to have the bed accessible from both sides of the bed. You can just have it accessible from one side of the bed and it will work out fine. So now I'm just putting some clutter in the bathroom as well. I put like a shelf above the toilet with some stuff and also some wall art. I love this season's wall art for the bedroom. And then of course the butterflies is so pretty. And then some wall art for the kitchen, you know, some fruits in a picture frame hanging on the wall. I mean, that's cool. And then just like some random flowers. And yeah, now I'm just rearranging the entrance, you know, like it's got everything you need, the umbrella rack, the coat rack, the shoe rack, and what else was it? Like a little basket thingy, just I don't know, to dump stuff. And then of course we need the boxes for the house decorations for when it's like the holidays. So I put that by the easel. Now I'm just rearranging the kitchen clutter, trying to figure out how to position it best, you know, make the most out of what little I put in here. And for this spoon jug thing, I put it somewhere on the fridge, you know, like why not. And then by the stove, I like putting tile background because it's easier to clean the oil off the tile background than a painted wall. So that's why I do that there. It's just, it also creates something a bit different in that area. And now I'm like second guessing the lighting. So now I'm first playing around a bit. I'm putting lamps around and then I put these wall lights. And yeah, so I got rid of that saucer light and then I put these wall lights in the lamps, which I think is really cool. It gives a different lighting, so it's not that bright lighting, but it's still bright enough for me, for my standards, because I like bright light. And yeah, so now we're doing the backyard. So I've been like, when I'm making budget builds, I get so annoyed that I can't put a swimming pool right. So in this build, I could actually put a swimming pool. Like, I'm so happy about that. So I'm really like, that's why I say this budget build I did is really my most favorite build ever in the budget build genre. So I'm just super happy that this build could have a swimming pool. So for a cheap house, it has a swimming pool. That's like really amazing. And now I'm just like checking out the debug life edit stuff for some fencing. Obviously it is for free, we don't pay for this, so there we can also do some cuts on the budget. We don't have to pay for the fencing. I did notice though, when playtesting, your sim walks through the fence. So yeah, I'm just letting you guys know that your sim will walk through the fence. So if that's a problem for you, you're gonna have to save up money and buy a actual fence. But for me, it's not a problem because it looks really cool. So, and it's for free. So yeah, by the sides, I did struggle a bit to close it off because of the size of the fence. So I just sized it down. And then the other side, I sized down a bit more than the first side. But then I do cover it with free plants as well for the garden. yeah, so you don't really see that part. And I guess since the Sims anyways walk through it, it wouldn't really matter. But since I do cover it with plants, your Sims won't walk through that part of the yard. So that is fine. And yeah, so first I put down like some plants and stuff. But then when I get around to the front yard's gardening, I decide to use a specific type of plant. So then I just kind of like change some stuff in the backyard because I wanted it to match the front yard. But first I'm trying to like, you know, cover up that fencing that I had to size down. And then I put these bushes in like against the house, but I don't know, something did not sit right with me with these bushes. I feel like these bushes are a bit skew. And yeah, and you see, I'm just like, it looks messy at the moment. Like, I was not really happy with that. And landscaping is not my best skill. But I have been improving by limiting myself to use just a select few plants, because previously I used to just throw a bunch of different plants in. But now I'm trying to like just use select few plants, and these white ones are my most favorite. I really love them. So the Life Edit debug ones are like bigger than the normal ones you would buy. I mean, you can size it up and down as well, but I left it big because then it fills more space and I can put less stuff in the garden, so less work for me. I think that's like a win-win. So for our backyard with the swimming pool, we also have a barbecue area. So like, this house has everything, man, that I am looking for, except a computer. That's one thing this house does not have, is like a computer for gaming. So that's the only thing I'm missing from this house. But in any case, further, it has everything. There's even planter pots and stuff. So now I'm just like gonna rearrange a bit. And oh yes, even the swing set from Seasons, like, really love this house. But like I was saying, it is getting near the end of the video, so before it is finished, I would like to say thank you to you guys for watching my video. I really do appreciate it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments, what do you think of this house? And if you have like any suggestions for other type of budget builds you would like me to make, or pack limited budget builds, drop that in the comments and I can check it out. But yeah, you guys must have a lovely day. Further, don't forget to like and subscribe. Poison out.